To load 3D SEG-Y, first open the Dug Insight launcher. Click Open Project to open an existing project directory. Select SEG-Y Loader as the application you want to launch. The SEG-Y Loader does not require much memory. The default 200 MB is recommended. Click Launch to run the SEG-Y Loader. The SEG-Y Loader is a wizard-based tool that leads you through the process of importing SEG-Y formatted data into Insight. I will load a 3D volume in time as post-stack traces. I'll add my SEG-Y file. If the data is spread across multiple files, they can be selected here. SEG-Y data is made of various headers and trace data values. Insight will use SEG-Y standard values as default settings and allow you to override these values if necessary. Checking the headers allows you to confirm that the values are correct. The Obsidic header typically contains information such as the client, survey company, parameters, and processing used. It can also contain coordinate and CRS information. Binary contains sample interval, samples per trace, and the data format. The trace header contains inline crossline, XY, XY scalar, and the start time. Insight will determine the most likely byte locations of the key information and highlight the values in bold font. By changing the number of traces, you can see the range of values at the listed byte locations. Looking at the Obsidic header, it suggests that inline and crossline are stored in bytes 189 and 193, which matches the trace headers. The Obsidic also suggests the XYs are stored in bytes 181 and 185, but the trace header is listing bytes 73-77. Misleading information in Obsidic headers and non-standard mappings like this are common with SEG-Y data. If the trace header does not match your knowledge of the data, try looking at the standard locations. If this does not help, display all the byte locations. Here we can confirm the bytes 181 and 185 are in fact value 0, and the suggested X and Y trace headers are correct. Finally, you can view the traces to make sure the selected sample looks okay. You can choose to manually enter the survey geometry later or have it extracted from the SEG-Y headers. The default locations are stored in bytes 181 and 185, but we have learned from our analysis that our SEG-Y uses bytes 73 and 77. To create a decimal precision using an integer value storage, a coordinate scalar may have been applied, which can be specified here. If there is a difference in CRS between the SEG-Y file and the project, the coordinates will be converted during import. Filter data to exclude ranges of values based on inline, crossline, and XY, and so on. Analyze the data to detect any problems and the extensive survey to be loaded. Blue text means no errors. I need to save the computed survey by giving it a name and checking the parameters before clicking Next. To output the data, I need to provide a name to identify the volume. The data is stored as a WO file. I select a class to determine the default display properties of the data. Optimized volumes are not required, but will decrease the display times considerably. Turning this option off and generating them later will speed up the loading process. I can provide a step increment multiple of the original spacing if I want to decimate the data. I can use the Advanced section to change the output format type. Once the writing process is completed, click Finish to exit the SEG-Y loader. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dog.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!